A lot of you have been asking what the difference between Softr and Stacker is. I get this question more than any other question over the last 6 months. Which one should I use for my business? Which one is better, Stacker or Softr? In this video, we are jumping into the details to answer that very question. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Hey, welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth, and we help you to organize and automate your business using no-code tools. So if that's of interest and you want to learn more about that, do check out the links below. Be sure to subscribe to this channel. And if you want a crash course webinar on exactly how I use automation to save up to 20 hours of my time every week, there's a little bonus for you below. You can check out the link. It's garethpronovost.com/webinar-registration, and it is a live webinar. I do it once a week. I'm going to show you exactly the steps you need to implement in order to really leverage powerful automation for you without knowing how to code. All right, enough of all that. Let's get into the heart of this video. We've got to talk about Stacker versus Softr. Now, quick time out, full transparency here. I've worked with and continue to work with both Stacker and Softr. I think both of the platforms are incredible. I've done numerous videos on both of these platforms, and yet people continue to ask, you know, what is the difference? Why would I pick one over the other? Which one should I use for my business? Which one's best? Now, if you're looking for me to just come out and say straight up, this software is better, you are going to be disappointed. And that is because I think that both of these software choices are really created for two specific different clients. So let's talk about really what they do, how they're different, and therefore help you to decide which one of them is a better fit for you. Now, I knew we would be doing this video at some point, so a couple of months ago, I posted a question on my YouTube channel, and I just sent this out to all of our followers, and I said, hey, what matters the most to you when you're building a front end for your database? So I guess we should start by defining the fact that Softr and Stacker are both helping you to build a more intuitive front end for your data that lives usually in Airtable. Now, usually is a little asterisk, and we're gonna come back to that. But for me, and probably for most of their users, we started working in Airtable as the back end. That's where we created our data structure, and then we ran into a roadblock. Specifically, the roadblock of not being able to share the right data with the right people in an intuitive way, right? Airtable, of course, allows you to share your views, but views are read-only. And so if you want to do anything more interactive, or if you just want to build a really great UI where people are seeing very specific things depending on who they are and what they've been assigned to, well then, suddenly, Airtable alone is no longer a complete solution for you. You need that front-end UI, user interface element, in order to interact with that back-end data. Now, I should point out before we go any further, there are other options out there. Pori.io, they have a great option that allows you to build a front-end for your database. Also, miniextensions.com, very cool platform. They have all kinds of fun tools that you can use to really further enhance the data that you store in Airtable. But for the purpose of this video, we are talking about Softr and Stacker, and we're gonna deep dive on these three things. Now, going into my poll that I sent out several months ago, now I was curious about this. What matters most to you folks who are building things in these different tools? Is it the price? Do you want an inexpensive solution so that you can get that enhanced customization without having to pay a lot? Or is it functionality? Do you want to have a really robust, you know, set of features so that your users can do a lot more with that app or software that you build? Or is it customization? Do you want to have a high level of customization so that you can place things in your interface exactly where you want them and have, you know, really the sky's the limit in terms of how you develop your app or software? Well, the numbers don't lie. A small majority of 39% decided that customization was actually the most important thing for them. Now, I find this to be interesting and surprising, frankly, because for me, my personal use case here, I need high level of functionality. I absolutely have to be able to do the task. I really don't care all that much about what the customization looks like. If there's a bell in the upper right corner, or this text is emboldened, or any of that stuff, that is always secondary to me to pure functionality. But again, different users are gonna need different things. So let's talk about each one of these in more detail. All right, so the really cool thing about Softr is that you get a very high level of customization inside of the software. You can add blocks, and blocks allow for a number of different types of things. So you have your hero section, or your call to action, or, you know, partner listings or testimonials. But really what it comes down to at a certain point is building that interface with your data. All of these other pieces are really cool, but they're really only helpful in the sense of building a web app, right? And getting the page to look like the way you need it to. The functionality comes down in the list, and this is where you're connecting to your Airtable data and displaying it on your web app on any number of pages that you build in that app. Now, by contrast, in my opinion, Stacker doesn't have the same level of customization. You don't have the ability to add blocks in quite the same way that you do inside of Softr. So when working inside of Stacker, and if you're editing your layout, sure, you can change your header, which is the section up at the top. You can change how your records are displayed, but ultimately every single page inside of your app for Stacker is going to be a representation of the underlying data that lives somewhere. Usually Airtable, but again, we're coming back to that asterisk at a moment in the future. So from my perspective, if we're speaking specifically to customization, I think that Softr has an edge over Stacker in this particular category. You get to customize the layout of your interface with a higher degree of detail inside of Softr as opposed to Stacker. Now let's talk about functionality. We want to pull in data from many tools. Well, which is the better fit for that? Looking at Softr and looking at the data options, when we go to bring data in, it is simply an option to connect to Airtable. So your data must live in Airtable in order to be displayed in your Softr app. Now, on the other hand, if we're looking at adding an app in Stacker, we get prompted to either access data in Airtable or in Google Sheets. I think this is a bigger deal than people give it credit for the simple reason that if Airtable decided to build a front end of their own someday, how would these softwares, both Softr and Stacker, how would they continue to operate? Would they be made obsolete, or would they have continuing staying power as front end portals or interfaces to build in the no-code environment? At present, if Airtable were to take that step today, I think that Softr might be in a little bit of trouble, right? All of their data connections are currently through Airtable. So if Airtable built their own front-end UI, I don't know why somebody would necessarily go and pay for Softr if they could just get the same functionality in Airtable. I just don't know how much staying power a company would have if they only focused on one data source. And this is why when Stacker recently announced that they were connecting to multiple data sources, and Google Sheets as proof of that here on my screen, as soon as that announcement was made, I thought that that added additional staying power to Stacker's potential in the long term for being a portal or front end tool for no code. Again, this is going to come down to where's your data stored and do you want to always keep your data there? At the end of the day, it doesn't matter so much if they connect to multiple different tools or not, if all of your data is in one place. So this is very much a personal decision on your part to determine which is the better fit for you. So in short, my personal preference is a front end that connects to multiple data sources. And so for me personally, I think that Stacker comes out a winner in this category. Now let's talk about the third category I threw out, which is price. Obviously, these tools have very different pricing, so we should discuss exactly what that is so that you can make the best decision for you. Softr's pricing, listed on their website at present, they have a freemium model, so they do have a free option. I'll switch over to the monthly option so that you can see, as most people tend to pay monthly. You're looking at $30 a month for the starter, $79 a month for the professional and $199 per month for the business. This obviously has an increased amount of accessibility and permissions that come along with it. But if you were to take the middle tier of prices and say $79 and kind of compare that to Stacker, over on Stacker's side, also looking at the monthly payment, they're starting out at $79 a month, up to $179 in their middle tier, and then $349 for their higher tier. So obviously, again, it's not an apples to apples comparison because there are different things offered in each tier. So I would definitely recommend that you go to check that out. But if we just take the two middle tiers, $79 a month for Softr and $179 a month for Stacker, obviously Softr is on the less expensive side. Although I don't know that you're gonna get the right functionality at every stage of that game. So again, make sure to jump in for yourself and look at the pricing. Make sure that whatever features you need are within the price tiers that you're comparing. So that is how this software stacks up in these three categories. I think that these are three very important categories to consider, but it's not the whole picture. Ultimately, I think we need to consider what the software is best designed to accomplish. So let's talk about that in general. Stacker was specifically created for teams to build no-code tools and create portals to their data. Now, they have done that incredibly well. And with that, they have helped a large number of customers who are incredibly loyal to them, and they continue to grow and grow. They are, in my opinion, the go-to solution for building an online portal. Yes, they're a little pricier, but they have a lot of features and functionality that no one else on the market really offers in such a complete package. Now, specifically, I'm thinking about the fact that as a user inside of Stacker, I can edit an existing Airtable record within my portal. Now, this is not currently something that Softr allows for. Now, I have it on good authority that it will be here with us within a few weeks of this recording, but if it's my intent as a developer to build a custom portal for internal purposes, I absolutely must have edit capability for my users. I can't imagine an example where I would build an internal portal and not want to edit existing data and instead be confined to only create new records. So for me, this is why Stacker is the clear winner when it comes to building an internal portal as their current features of both software are considered. Now, on the other hand, where does that leave Softr? Well, Softr is an incredible tool for building web apps and membership sites. These are two things that Stacker can't do whatsoever. The Stacker UI is more rigid and it doesn't allow for that level of flexibility. But inside of the Softr interface, which is much more flexible, you can build a lot more of these different types of ancillary tools. Membership sites, for example, or web pages / web apps. The sky is really the limit when it comes to the flexibility that Softr has allowed you as a developer. So if you're looking to build a membership site or a website, Softr is the clear winner in this heads-up match. I hope you got a ton of value from this video, and if nothing else, I hope that it helped get the wheels turning and point you in the direction of a software that's gonna help you build the front end that you need. Anyway, that's it for this video. Thanks so much for checking it out. If you have any questions or comments, I would love to hear them below, even if you disagree with something I said here, and I will see you in the next video. As always, I hope you found that to be extremely helpful. If you did and you'd like to learn more, swing by our website and see how we can help. We offer a free Airtable crash course that will help you level up in Airtable quickly, and we also have some paid services, including hourly consultations with our experts. We have some online courses and a group coaching program, and for advanced needs, we can build a bespoke solution for you from scratch. So swing on by, and I look forward to connecting with you soon.